My talk is about very low energy oxygen ion outflows during geomagnetic storms based on Akebono and Polar observations. In the inner magnetosphere, oxygen ions increase during storm main phase. This panel shows the oxygen ion density in this energy range in the inner magnetospheric region. During main phase, the oxygen density suddenly increases. This indicates the ionospheric plasma transported to inner magnetosphere and energizations also occur. One of the important outflow mechanisms, ion outflow from the dayside region called the cleft fountain is suggested. This is a schematic of cleft ion outflow. The ions come from in the dayside, and fast and light ions go up. On the other hand, slow and heavy ions flow deeper into the polar cap and lobe region. So ions flow into the polar cap owing to the velocity filter effect of the cleft ion fountain. However, in the polar cap and at high altitude, density is low. So the satellite charges positively, and thus low energy ion normally difficult to observe. But in the storm time, electron density increase and the S-class potential reduce. So we show the some observations of this very low energy component of the cleft ion fountain in the dayside polar cap and electron density enhancement at about 9,000 kilometer altitude during geomagnetic storms. And we discussed significance of this very low energy ion outflow through the dayside polar cap in the oxygen ion supply to the magnetosphere. We use Akebono and polar satellite data. In situ electron density derived from plasma waves, upper hybrid resonance wave and Poitras mode wave are used. Observed electron densities are normalized relative to the quiet time level. The Akebono also observe very low energy ions about the spacecraft potential to 20 electron volts. Ion composition ratio and parallel velocities and temperatures are calculated. The flux are calculate using the total electron density and composition ratio and parallel velocities, and mapped to 1,000 kilometer altitude. The polar satellite measure low energy ions down to about 0.3 electron volt. Although the data are integrated over all masses, we identify the peak that corresponds to oxygen ions, and we calculate parallel velocity, number of flux, and temperatures for the peak correspond to oxygen ions. This is a storm time observation by the Akebono satellite. This panel shows the normalized electron density by the quiet time level. During main phase of geomagnetic storm, very high electron density that is higher than about 30 times compared to the quiet time level is observed. This is a trajectory of the Akebono satellite. In this case, it is the altitude is about 9,000 kilometers. Akebono satellite come across the dayside polar cap from dawn side to dusk side, and the thin black lines show the convection. The high density region are very widely spread in the dayside. Next, we show more detail. This red line shows observed density, and this black line shows quiet time level. These panels show low energy electrons and low energy ions. In the polar cap region, low energy ions are not present in energy range above about 10 electron volts. These three panels show the observations of thermal ions. This is composition and velocity and temperature in the region of significant electron density enhancement in the polar cap, ions were dominated by cold about order of 1 eV and upflowing velocity of 4 to 10 kilometers per second oxygen ions. The velocity corresponds to only 1 to 8 electron volts. This ion composition is similar to that of the Krefeld fountain. But this velocity is not so large. So we calculated particle trajectory based on the Akebono observation using Tsiganenko and Weimar model, and no, assuming no parallel electric field. Since this period, no solar wind data are available, so we assumed an idealized storm main phase with southward IMF of 20 nanotesla and solar wind velocity of 500 kilometers per second, density of 10 per cubic centimeter. We launched ions from dayside at 9,000 kilometer altitude. The different color indicate different initial velocity. Oxygen ions with initial velocities of only 2 kilometers per second can reach the equatorial plane owing to the strong centrifugal force during storm time. So we have to take into account such a low energy ions when we think about ion supply to the magnetosphere. This is another event. This is the normalized electron density. The Akebono satellites observe significantly enhanced electron densities during the main to early recovery phase, about 15 hours continuously. This is a polar plot of the Akebono satellite. In this case, the high density are observed in the day side. This is the data, observed data at about 7,000 kilometer altitude. In this case, density, electron density reached about 1,000 per cubic centimeter. So it is very high density in the polar cap. At the same time, polar satellite crossed the polar cap near the Akebono satellite pass. Next, we show this observation. The time period is near the peak of this magnetic storm. This is the electron data, and this is low energy ion data observed by the polar satellite. In the polar cap, ions are mostly below the 10 eV, and this peak corresponds to the oxygen ions based on the knowledge of equilibrium drift velocity. Next, we show moments of this period. In this case, the satellite crossed the polar cap from night side to day side. This is a moment collected using spacecraft motion and spacecraft potential data. The region of ion outflow are wider than the cusp. In this case, only the width of the cusp was about 1.6 degree, but the outflow region is extended to about 10 degree. And the flux is very large, 10 to the 9th, mapped to 1,000 kilometer altitude, even low energy component. And the temperature is very low in the polar cap. Using the Akebono and polar observation, we roughly estimated the amount of the oxygen ions through this region, assuming this region as an outflow region, and observed flux was about order of 10 to the 9th. So estimated outflow rate became 10 to the 26th, order of 10 to the 26th per second. This rate is comparable to the total oxygen ion outflow rate in active magnetic condition estimated by Chappell et al. So the very low energy oxygen ion upflow in the dayside polar cap can play a major role in the トータルオキシンアイオンサプライ、デュアリティジョネティックストーン。This is the summary. Dwelling on just after main phases of genetic storms at solar maximum, electron density enhancements are observed、based on wave observation by the Akebono satellite.、the electron density enhancement in the dayside polar cap、corresponds at about 9,000 km altitude, corresponds to very low energy oxygen ion outflows. Owing to the strong convection and centrifugal force,Oxygen ions with upward velocity of only 2 kilometers per second at 9,000 km altitude can contribute to the ion supply to the magnetosphere during main phases. Long duration of electron density enhancements implies prolonged energy input and prolonged ion supply. The very low energy component of the cleft ion fountain will significantly contribute to total oxygen ion supply owing toVery high density. That's all. Thank you.
Any hands? Comments? Hearing none? Sorry. Alex.
Naritoshi, very nice、talk. I was wondering...Is, how unique is this observation? Do you have, are there lots of examples like this in the Akebono data set?
We have a lot of examples of electron density enhancements at a similar level, but in most of case, the for example, ion data are not available or the instrument are not in the proper mode to...At the moment, so we have few events that include ion data, but we have many events of electron density enhancement. So electron density enhancements are not rare phenomena, I think.
When you do your calculation of the outward flow velocity of the O plus with the centrifugal force. Is that a calculation assuming a single mass just moving along a flux tube at that velocity, or do you include some model of the electron distribution along the flux line so that you can include an ambipolar field?
In this case, we do not take into account the ambipolar electric field. So it is minimum case. And if upward ambipolar electric field include, it would reach far more down the tail.
I have one quick question. Can you comment on the difficulties of interpreting the electron density in the face of spacecraft floating potential?
I think the wave measurement is not affected by the spacecraft potential. And in some case, many type of waves can use to derive electron densities. And all of cutoff and resonance show same density. So I think the wave measurements are not affected by spacecraft potential.
Okay, thank you very much.